And welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition as we finish cleaning up Crestwood.
We've been searching the region for resources. Commander's orders. No small task given recent troubles, but I've some supplies here you may find useful.
Bull is just so squishy. Kind of a liability until you get him some gear that has a guard on hit function.
Save Crestwood from the dead. Watch out for the women in the hills. I'd take his hide if I were better with a bow.
There's a women causing trouble.
It used to hunt in the mountains. Didn't bother anyone but the bandits. Lately, the beast got it in his head to come down here. It almost crippled Gaul's little boy. Best someone kill it. I hope I get my hands on the liver. It makes a poison that kills rats like nothing.
I killed the Wyvern up in the cave. The body's yours if you want it.
That I do. Here, for your troubles. I hope you can make good use of it. A fine day to you.
If you're Judith, there's a man in the village concerned about you.
That must be Gould, fretful as ever. I'm glad he stayed in Crestwood. He's fast as you please with a loom, but terrible with a sword.
What do you know about the dragon?
She moved in a month ago. The guards tried to run her off, but she snapped one's head off and she flew away. Poor Hamald. At least it was quick. Since then, she's eaten 3 horses, 5 goats, and 2 cats.
Until later.
Be safe.
Seems like a waste of energy for a dragon to eat a cat. Liability. There's the answer to the liability right there. Most convenient. Thank you.
find it for ya. Hey, Rin, you know who I am? Let's be watchful. I understand this country's full of dogs. Warden pal should be inside that cave.
Glad you made it. I just got here myself. My contact with the Warden should be at the back of the cave.
A group of Wardens were protecting a villager from corpses out near Crestwood.
They were likely hunting my friend. I'm glad they didn't come looking for people to help in here. They might well be good men, but they've been given bad orders.
I like how they killed off the Grey Warden, Riordan, in the first Dragon Age, and then just recast his voice actor to play the next Grey Warden.
Let's go.
Just us. I brought the Inquisitor.
My name is Stroud, and I'm at your service, Inquisitor.
Most of you Wardens disappear. Then I run into a darkspawn magister named Corypheus. Do you think that one might have something to do with the other?
I fear it is so. When my friend Hawk slew Corypheus, Weishaupt was happy to put the matter to rest. But an archdemon can survive wounds that seem fatal, and I feared Corypheus might possess the same power. My investigation uncovered clues, but no proof. Then, not long after, every warden in Orlais began to hear the calling.
I recall that being a bad thing, but I don't recall you telling me about all this.
It was a Grey Warden matter. I was bound by an oath of secrecy.
Is the calling some sort of Grey Warden ritual?
The calling tells a warden that the Blight will soon claim him. Starts with dreams. Then come whispers in his head. The warden says his farewells and goes to the deep roads to meet his death in combat.
And every Grey Warden in Orlais is hearing that right now. They think they're dying.
Yes. Likely because of Corypheus. If the Wardens fall, who will stand against the next Blight? It is our greatest fear.
And then they do something desperate. Which is, of course, what Corypheus wants.
You said all the Wardens are hearing the calling. Does that include you?
Sadly, yes. It lurks like a wolf in the shadows around a campfire. The creature that makes this music has never known the love of the Maker, but at times, I almost understand it. We must uncover what Corypheus has done and end it. This cannot stand.
Is the calling they're hearing real, or is Corypheus mimicking it somehow?
I know not. Even as a senior warden, I had heard only the vaguest whispers of Corypheus. The wardens believe that this calling is real. And they will act accordingly. That is all we know for certain.
How can Corypheus make all these wardens hear the calling?
I cannot say. We know little about him, save that he is dangerous. He is a magister, as well as a darkspawn, and speaks with the voice of the Blight. That lets him affect the minds of wardens, since we are tied to the Blight ourselves. It must be how he created this false calling.
So the wardens think they're dying and have stopped thinking clearly. That won't go well.
We are the only ones who can slay archdemons. Without us, the next Blight will consume the world. Warden Commander Clarell spoke of a blood magic ritual to prevent future Blights before we all perished. When I protested the plan as madness, my own comrades turned on me. Grey Wardens are gathering here, in the Western Approach. It is an ancient Tevinter ritual tower. Meet me there, and we will find answers.
I heard what he said. Hopefully we'll find some answers in the Western Approach. Though I fear what those answers will be. I've seen too much blood magic to ever trust where it leads.
Yep, Hawk has run into a blood mage or two.
Well met, your worship.
Or 200 or 300. A lot, basically.
I found Butcher's corpse by the south road. Venatori ambushed me afterward.
Only our highest operatives knew he was coming tonight. I must inform Sister Nightingale we have a traitor.
I should be going.
Never need that. Not quite ready to take the dragon on yet, so I think before we head back to Skyhold, I'm gonna get this this quest knocked out here. Which way is this guy?
It's another one, isn't it?
I don't need these things. I can just run.
Of course, but it is another one.
And get all the dialogue option ones now.
Inquisitor?
My scouts report no signs of danger in the pass nearby.
I will arrange patrols to ensure it stays that way.
Let's see what we have. Our agents have encountered more followers of Corypheus, these so-called Venatori. Their leader, Calpurnia, has them searching elven ruins. For what, I do not know. I propose we stop the Venatori before they find what they seek.
Do you know anything about Calpurnia?
Only that Calpurnia is a name from ancient Tevinter legend. An unusual one. She was a priestess of Dumat, foster mother to the founder of the Imperium. A name like that is meant to assure the Venatori they follow in the footsteps of legends. We must prove them wrong.
Calpurnia must be up to something. Corypheus doesn't seem the type to suffer idleness.
I will not let her and Corypheus take us unawares again. These Venatori have been shadowing a merchant called Vicinius on Calpurnia's orders. They've investigated his finances, surveyed his warehouses. I propose that you meet with Vicinius. Flatter him. Find out what he knows of Calpurnia.
Vicinius sounds like a Tevinter name.
Born in Tallo. Although he claims to be from Virantium. He sells rare oils and amber. And prefers red wine to white.
What side of the bed does he sleep on?
He's unremarkable. I cannot think why Calpurnia would care.
What if Vicinius is as much in the dark as we are?
It never hurts to eliminate an avenue of inquiry. And we should tread lightly with the Venatori. They have contacts and spies, just as we do. The sooner you speak with Vicinius, the better.
We need him to open up about these bloodthirsty cultists. I'll bring wine.
Vicinius could be a useful ally. Merchants travel. And they love gossip as much as coin. I'll make arrangements for you to visit his summer home in Valrayo. Hopefully, your attention should be enough to pique his interest. We'll have Calpurnia's secrets yet.
Go ahead and do that right this minute.
Even death must be pretty and fresh.
Disaster is what it is, and you know it.
Theirs were not the only houses affected by the loss of heaven. According deeper than death to a name.
You must control yourself in front of the worshippers, sister.
They pose the question. It's that.
Inquisitor, welcome. Thanks to your investment, I have all manner of runners scouring the wake of your adventures. If there's a tome that eludes you, I will endeavor to fill the gaps. I will not deny you a good story nor valuable information.
By all the Redcliffe codexes.
What happened?
And where is the merchant we intended to meet?
Somebody decorated the walls with this guy.
By sending her mistreated slaves.
Really? Most Interventor wouldn't bother to care.
She was paying a fortune for literate slaves. Why? What can slaves do that Venatori can't? An invoice for a shipment of slaves.
Vicinius was selling more than rose oil then. Seems the Venatori tired of following him.
Let's look around. A shattered crystal. Let's find the pieces. Here's another one. Whole again, but hold on.
Lady Calpurnia, I had no intention.
I warned you of consequences should the slaves you bring me suffer in your care. Venatori, show him my displeasure.
No, Wait!
A dwarven relic, restoring memories. There's one or two in Minrathus. Very rare.
Dagna might know what to make of it.